Golden Age of Art. In this video we will deal with Pericles' decision to rebuild the temples destroyed by the Persians, the main monuments of the Acropolis of Athens, the sculpture in the classical era, the painting in the classical period. Pericles decided to rebuild the temples that the Persians had destroyed, using money from the Athenian Alliance Fund. He even commissioned his friend, Phidias, to personally supervise the works. General view of the Acropolis in classical times. The first monument that one would meet when going up to the Acropolis was the Propylaea. It was the entrance to the Acropolis. The construction of the Propylaea was undertaken by the architect Mnesicles. The Propylaea were finished within 5 years, 437 to 432 BC. The original plan, symmetry of the south wing with the north, was not completed due to the Peloponnesian War. The central building of the Propylaea consists of two parts, of which the eastern one is more elevated. The western side of the Propylaea. It is noteworthy that despite the purely Doric appearance on the exterior, the six interior columns were Ionic. The interior of the Propylaea. The eastern side of the Propylaea. On the left, the Stoa of Artemis Baronia. The Pinakotheke. The north wing is dominated by the rectangular building of the Pinakotheke where, according to Pausanias, there were many remarkable paintings, mainly by Polygnotus, which unfortunately have been lost today. The Propylaea today. A story about the help of the goddess Athena. During the rebuilding of the Propylaea, the most skilled worker slipped and fell from above. He was in bad shape and the doctors thought he would die. Pericles was very sad. Suddenly in his sleep the goddess Athena appeared to him and showed him the way in which the craftsman would be cured. He immediately took him to the doctors. Soon the injured craftsman was healed. In this way the interest of the goddess Athena in the works was shown. In memory of all this, they erected on the Acropolis the bronze statue of Athena, Wygia, which was made by Phidias, as well as the golden statue of Athena. In front of the south wing of Propylaea was built the small Ionic temple of Athena Nike, the construction of which was undertaken by the architect Callicrates. Here was the archaic Zoano of Athena, 427 to 421 BC. View from northwest. The temple of Athena Nike with its altar. The temple of Athena Nike today. At the highest point of the Acropolis rock was the Parthenon, also dedicated to goddess Athena. The Parthenon is the most important work of Greek architecture. 447 to 438 BC. Let's watch a video of the 3D reconstruction of the Parthenon to learn more about this marvel of Greek architecture.
Thank you.
According to the video, on the years when Greece was in the hands of the Turks, the English Lord Elgin visited Athens. With the help of the Turks, he removed part of the Parthenon sculptures and brought them home. Today they are exhibited in the British Museum, but the Greek Ministry of Culture is making efforts to return the Parthenon sculptures. In the Greek Museum we exhibit plaster copies of the sculptures that are missing and are in the British Museum. Acropolis Museum. Parthenon Hall. In the place where, according to legend, the fight between Athena and Poseidon to decide who would give his name to the city of Athens took place, Erechtheion was built. Its architect was Mnesicles, 421-407 BC. View from southwest. Remnants of the dispute between Athena and Poseidon for the ownership of the city are the olive tree that the goddess gave to the city and is located to the west of the building, and the traces of Poseidon's trident on the rock from which he spouted salt water. View from northwest. The Erechtheion is the holiest place of worship in Athens. Apart from Athena, Poseidon, Hephaestus, Cecropa, the mythical first king of Athens, and the local heroes Erechtheus and Bautes were worshipped there. The main characteristic of the Erechtheion is the southern projection of the Caryatides, the columns in the form of women. Under the Caryatides was the tomb of the first mythical king of Athens, Cecropas. One of the Caryatides was removed by Lord Elgin and is now in the British Museum. A story by Zoe Valesis about Caryatides. One day, an English lord came to Acropolis to take out and take with him the 6 marble daughters. He took one and left orders for the Turks to go at night to take out and carry the others to him. Indeed, at night the Turks went to take the daughters, but, when they went up to the castle, they were almost mad with fear. The marble daughters were crying and calling for their sister who had been taken away by the milord, and the whole place echoed with their lamentations. The Turks ran away and they didn't even want to ever come back to harm the daughters again. Many people under the castle heard the daughters crying at night and asking for their sister. In the Museum of the Acropolis, 5 of the 6 original Caryatides are on display. Their copies are in Erechtheion. The Erechtheion today. The surrounding area was full of dedications. Among them was a creation of Phidias, the copper statue of Athena, which was 7 meters high. It was Athena Promachos who symbolized the victory at Marathon, 460 BC. The tip of Athena's spear could be seen from far away, from Soyunion. On the Acropolis there were various other auxiliary buildings, sanctuaries and altars. The main ones are the Sanctuary of Artemis of Baronia, the Chalcotec, Tauhi Archaic Temple of Athena Pallada, the Araphorion, Tauhi Sanctuary of Zeus Polius, Tauhi Sanctuary of Pandion. The Sanctuary of Artemis of Baronia, the patroness of women and childbirth, probably functioned as an annex to the large sanctuary in Vravrona, Attica. Tauhi offerings of the faithful were kept in the side wings. In its courtyard there was a bronze statue of the Trojan horse. The Chalcotec was a place where the numerous bronze votive offerings, statues, weapons, utensils, offered by the faithful to Athena were kept. The archaic temple of Athena Pallada that was destroyed by the Persians. Its operation continued after the repair of a part of the cella, perhaps the opisthodomos. The Araphorion with its courtyard from the southwest. In the courtyard there was a small staircase leading to the city. The Araphorion was a square building in the northwestern part of the Acropolis. It was the residence of the 2 Herphoroi, 2 girls aged 7 to 11 years old, who were chosen every year to weave the veil of Athena with which they covered the zoano of goddess during the festival of the Panathenians. In the sanctuary of Polius Zeus ox sacrifices were made during the celebrations of the dipoles. For this reason, in archaic times, oxen were bred there, as can be seen from an inscription prohibiting the throwing of dung to the west of the temple. The sanctuary of Pandion was dedicated to the mythical hero and king Pandion, son of Erythonius or Kecropa. This was where the Pandionian tribe, one of the 10 tribes of Athens, performed its various ceremonies. The old Acropolis Museum is located in its place today. Let's see now the sculpture of the classical period. How are the statues made during this period? The statues made during this period were different than the kurus and the cores of the archaic period. The satellite of the Polyclitus, in comparison to the koros of Anavisos, has natural and realistic features in the face, an air of movement in the body and ideal body proportions. Also his chest and knees are rendered with plasticity, while the koros is linear. The discus thrower of Myron. And the teenager of Marathon. The Iniochos of Delphi. Kori of Acropolis. And Tanagria Kori. What do we know about painting in classical period? The reconstruction of this part of Parthenon frieze, Sophoros, which is in the British Museum, shows that originally the marbles were covered with paint. Paintings were difficult to save. However, we can get an idea of how the painters painted from the representations on the vessels. Why was the era in which Pericles lived called the Golden Age? First of all, Athens then experienced a great economic and cultural boom. Additionally, these works that glorified Athens were considered classical, that is, they remained unsurpassed through the centuries. That's why the era in which Pericles lived was called the Golden Age. And now it's time to watch a very moving video about the gradual deconstruction of Parthenon.
Thank you. 'Twas thus Athena spake. That blush of shame proclaims thee Britain, once a noble name. First of the mighty, foremost of the free, now honored less by all and least by me. Chief of thy foes shall Pallas still be found. Seek'st thou the cause of loathing? Look around. Law here, despite of war and wasting fire, I saw successive tyrannies expire, scaped from the ravage of the Turk and Goth. Thy country sends a spoiler worse than both. Survey this vacant, violated fane. Recount the relics torn that yet remain. These Cecrops placed, this Pericles adorned. What more I owe, let gratitude attest. No, Alaric and Elgin did the rest, that all may learn from whence the plunderer came. The insulted wall sustains his hated name. Be ever hailed with equal honor here, the Gothic monarch and the Elgin peer. Arms gave the first his right, the last had none, but basely stole what less barbarians won. So, when the lion quits his fell repast, next prowls the wolf, the filthy jackal, last, some calm spectator, as he takes his view in silent indignation mixed with grief, admires the plunder, but abhors the thief.